You know, we've encountered a couple nice bucks, actually three really nice bucks here. In fact, we've got two of them. We've got some really good pics of them on the Reconyx cameras. There's nothing more we'd like to do than to put an arrow through the lungs of one of them deer this evening. Conditions are great. I think it's going to drop down to the 50s this evening. Kind of warm right now, but not a lot of humidity, so I think it's going to be a good evening.
With a couple of bucks in mind, Dan had eased in with the buggy and was headed to the Green Hornet. This was a box blind set that overlooked a waterhole and an imperial whitetail clover food plot. Being this was the first time in this set, Dan and Joe got settled in with much anticipation for the afternoon's hunt.
We got in plenty early and we were all set up. So I peeked out the window and the does were already out in the field. I like to range those does because at any time a buck could be walking in the same spot where those does just been. After a while, a young buck walked across the field with a gobbler. Man, that's pretty neat stuff. Things were looking really good, and at any time, a shooter buck could step out.
Dan, there he is. Our old buck,
yeah. So Joe looks out the window. He says, Dan, you're not going to believe this, but no score is on the field. And I couldn't believe it, so I had to look out the window. Sure enough, he was standing there on the edge of the field. So I started moving chairs around. I grabbed my bow. I was getting all ready because this is an animal I'd been hunting for 3 years, and I couldn't believe it. This early, he was on the field.
Yeah, there he is. He's just feeding right now. Man, what a brute. He's slowly coming this way. Here he is. He's in no hurry right this moment. Yeah, he's starting to look at these deer. Clear across the field, there's some other deer.
So there he is. He's feeding, he's calm, and he's looking across at the deer on the other end of the field. For the moment, there's no shot, so all we can do is wait.
If he starts to move this way, I think the best, I don't know which window you're gonna film out of, but there's that one in the middle might serve best because I'm gonna pop this window open here in just a second. Okay, here he comes. Get ready.
Everything's on schedule. No score is feeding along. Everything's cool. He's gonna be in front of us any second now. Then all of a sudden, he breaks into a trot and he's heading towards those deer on the other side of the field. So Joe scrambles towards the window to get the camera in position. I open the window and I'm in a hurry to get in front of him because he's almost walking out of the window frame. I'm at full draw now.
Huh? Watch him. Looks like I drilled his last rib. He was walking, so I couldn't steady, but I think I got him right through the last rib. That's an old buck. We've been calling him No Score because he's an old buck that, you can't go by his score, you gotta go by his age. You know, bucks like that don't come easy. It's a big old smart buck.
Before the break, Dan put an arrow in an old elusive deer he called No Score. Let's pick up the trail as Pete helps Dan recover his buck.
I'm telling you, look at the mass on this boy. Whoa. Daggum, look at the bases, Pete.
Oh, that's awesome.
The big old bases.
7-inch bases.
I'm telling you. You know, we've had all kinds of experience with this buck. We've got trail pics of him, we encountered him last year, and then the other night, night before last, we saw him all the way across the field. Joe and I closed the gap and everything went according to script. It just, and that don't happen too often.
No, especially early season to get a big deer on the ground like this, big mature animal, fool him.
Ah, man. You know, a lot of times people get hung up on score. I know with me, as with you, we're all about age. When an animal gets to this age, And actually, when they're on the decline, yep, that's when they're more attractive to me. Because yeah, he's made it through, he's survived a lot of battles, a lot of seasons.
Yeah, he's already been fighting this year. His nose is all tore up already.
Oh, yeah. He's a brute. Oh, man. Cool.
Thanks. Congratulations.
Thank you, buddy.
It's just the 3rd of October, and one of the hit list bucks is on the ground. Very old animal that had eluded Dan for the past two seasons. Now let's step back when we dismantled the killing shack and erected the ranger station. It's been 2 weeks since taking out No Score. October 15th is the date. A new blind, lush food plot, and a new stand of warm season grass sets the stage for the evening set.
You know, the other night we encountered a really nice buck we call Busy. It was a little windy that day, and the deer were moving a little late. As a result, Busy did everything he was supposed to do. I mean, we had him at 20 yards. I was locked on his ribs, ready to go, and Joe pulled me off. Wasn't enough light, you know. I've been thinking about that buck ever since, and today, it's not near as windy. It may drop the temperature a little bit. I don't know about that, but the fact that it's not as windy, we're hoping maybe he'll come out again. He didn't catch us. That's the good thing. And most of the time, you don't get a crack at him twice. You know, you see him, then you don't see him again this time of year, but who knows, maybe. We'll see what happens. You know, things are starting to look good. We got a lot of deer in the field. I mean, we got does on every side. We got spikes, several young bucks. Got this older six out there. So, I mean, things are looking real good. The sun's starting to go down a little bit, just on the edge of the tree. So, I mean, it's prime time. Anything can happen anytime. There's another buck. What's a nice buck? You know what? That looks like Busy. Is that Busy?
I don't know. I think so.
Man, it's hard to tell. Look at him. He's posturing with those bucks. Some young bucks are running for him.
Yeah, he's got those splits. I think it's him.
Oh, yeah. That's Busy. Look at him. He's pushing around those other bucks. He is he's the dominant buck.
So again, we're on BBA, aka Big Buck Acres, in the heart of Pike County. Dan Perez has his target buck Busy on the field. With plenty of daylight, things look to be leaning in Dan's favor.
So I took the curtain down, got my bow ready, knocked an arrow. I'm all set. The only problem is this buck's taking forever. He walks out into the field, trying to establish the pecking order. He starts shoving this one buck around. Then he hooks around and starts pushing this other buck. He's meeting every buck on the field. Then he walks down the edge and grabs a thicket of millet, starts thrashing it back and forth, back and forth. The bucks are looking at him and I'm looking at him. By now, my heart's beating because this is exciting stuff. Then he lets loose the millet and he's walking right down the edge. And if he stays steady on course, any moment we're gonna get a shot. It was a good hit, of course. You never know, because a lot of times deer move, do different things when you shoot, but boy, it just looked like it was tucked right behind the shoulder. He went over there to the edge of the woods, and he staggered a little bit, but he stood for a little while, a little longer than I thought he should stand. So, I don't know, maybe we'll just wait a while and back out of here. When it gets dark, should be good. We'll find out here soon.
Before the break, Dan put an arrow through an old tight-racked buck he called Busy. Let's pick up with Dan as he gets his hands on him for the first time.
There he is. Oh man, look at the bases on that bad boy. And he's split in every direction. His G2 is split, his G3 is split. He's got a good 4 on that side. A little 5 coming out. He's 8 points and long, long brows. Awesome buck. You know, he's totally opposite of the buck we shot the other night. That buck was an old bruiser, but not a lot of points. Really on the downhill slide because he is so old. Now this guy, he's He's really busy. He's an old buck as well, but he's got everything going on. The only thing he lacks, if anything, is width. He doesn't have the width, but man, I'll take all these other points all day long. He's a really, really nice animal. We're blessed we got another chance at him and put the arrow where it belonged.